She is on a historic mission aboard the International Space Station. NASA astronaut Jessica Watkins, she has more up her sleeve.
Yeah, she and other women at NASA are on a mission to bring more women into the aerospace industry. CNN's Rachel Crane has that story.
250 miles above the Earth, history is being made. Jessica Watkins is the first black woman to do a long-duration mission on board the International Space Station.
I certainly would like to, you know, spend as much time in space as I can.
Despite her history-making mission, Watkins and NASA know diversity in space continues to be a problem. According to NASA, 622 people have been to space, yet only 75 of them have been women. That's just 12%. Speaking to CNN while orbiting in microgravity, Watkins says she is doing all she can to work toward a pipeline of young talent that is more diverse.
Investing in school programs and education.
Does the space industry have a gender inequality problem?
I think absolutely the entire aerospace industry, I'll add, has a gender inequality issue.
NASA Deputy Administrator Pam Melroy is taking action from the ground. As a former astronaut who made three trips to space and was one of only two women to command a space shuttle, she knows it's a tough problem to solve.
We're just ignoring untapped potential. We have to take the proactive steps to make that number more similar to what the average population is.
Liftoff of STS-7 and America's first woman astronaut.
Sally Ride was the first American to open the doors for women like Melroy with her historic mission to space in 1983. That opened the floodgates for a series of firsts. First female commander of the International Space Station, first black woman in space, first all-female spacewalk.
There were a lot of people who told me that women couldn't be pilots, couldn't be astronauts, but it is very tough when you are the first or the only, but I had a reason to keep going.
Still, nearly four decades after Ride's first flight, women make up just above 36% of NASA's active astronaut class.
We really have to go deeper in the academic channel.
Bridget Chapman is an executive who also chairs Women in Aerospace, and she says the key is to start young.
Middle schoolers, those little girls who are excited about science and math before someone whispers in their ear that they should look at a different profession.
Hey, everybody.
NASA has more plans for Watkins. She has been selected by the agency to be a part of her astronaut class for Artemis, a mission which plans to send the first woman and the first person of color to the moon. But she hasn't been chosen to make the journey yet. No matter who is selected, Melroy is convinced the impacts of sending a woman to the moon will be astronomical.
You can believe it if you see it. This is going to have an impact far beyond that lucky individual who I'm already jealous of.
Rachel Crane, CNN, New York.